Eric Bakker, the naturopath. What percentage of gut bacteria are destroyed when you take a course of antibiotics? That's a very interesting question, and that debate rages now for a long time amongst many healthcare professionals. I'm going to speak now from my personal experiences regarding people. I'm not going to speak regarding studies or other stuff that I read, just purely on my experiences in the clinic with many thousands of people over a long period of time, many taking antibiotics, many not taking them. So my experiences basically are it affects different people differently. Some people surprise me and will go, who appear quite healthy, who'll go on a round of penicillin for 7 to 10 days and they've never been well since. In fact, antibiotics have linked in many cases with irreversible damage to the microbiome, where the digestive system can take such a hammering that some people find they never ever return back to normal. That's a minority. But I've seen hundreds of cases like it. Now remember, I see people who the system has failed. They've either failed the system or the system's failed them, but they've come to me. And antibiotics, in many cases, can permanently alter the microbiome, particularly when they're taken at a young age. I really don't like antibiotics given to young people because they destroy the bowel flora so bad. Elderly people are the same. And in many instances, I've seen elderly people pass away quite quickly after antibiotics when they were given, you know, in their advancing years. They didn't have much microbiome left and it was quickly destroyed and they went downhill quick. However, I have seen many other cases where, the person was quite weak and ill but had to go on antibiotics and yet they weren't affected anywhere near as bad as I thought they would be. And I've seen a small percentage of cases where people were incredibly helped by antibiotics, where in spite of every treatment that we tried, everything failed. I went to antibiotics and they worked. So I'm not averse to antibiotics. Don't get me wrong. I'm not a doctor basher, okay? I really like them, but only maybe in 0.00%, 0.5% of cases I like them, which is probably less than 0.25%, okay? They are certainly overprescribed. And generally given, non-discriminately to a wide range of people. And many people get long-term serious side effects from antibiotics. Many people. I could open a full-time clinic and employ 4 or 5 doctors working all day just to treat people with antibiotic-induced damage. There is so much carnage out there. In my opinion, most of the carnage occurs because the patient was poorly prepped and they didn't finish off the treatment properly, meaning they weren't instructed to go on to probiotics and also, lactic acid producing, foods, cultured or fermented foods there to complete the picture, and also prebiotic foods. So if a person is going to go on an antibiotic for, say, a week or 10 days, in my opinion, it could take 3 to 6 months to sort of partially recover the gut from that week to 10 days and a year to fully recover. Now, imagine if you've been back to back with several courses. Or you've been on antibiotics for a whole year, you've basically destroyed your gut. It could take years, even a lifetime, for a gut to come right when you've been on a prolonged course of treatment. I see no benefit at all from people being on antibiotics for 6 months every day. To me, that's just madness. That's kind of stupidity. And in the years to come, it will be seen as a dumb kind of therapy. It just doesn't work. I've failed to see any case that responds with that kind of treatment where day in, day out for months they get put on these stupid drugs. Short term, okay, but not for 6 months. It's crazy. Now, what about my poor patient who's been on antibiotics for 18 months every day? Couldn't get much worse. Those people likely never recover. They recover, but not fully. They recover partially. So what do? You have to go on antibiotics. You're told you have to go on them. You have the course as short as possible, and you make sure, particularly prior to going on antibiotics, that you get your diet and lifestyle sorted. So you're eating very clean and healthy, you're getting plenty of sleep, you're allowing your body plenty of time for recuperation during that antibiotic treatment. When you're taking the antibiotics, you make absolutely sure you're not eating, lots of junk food, lots of alcohol. It's not a good idea. When you've finished your course of antibiotics, probiotics. And particularly eating the right kind of foods, which we speak a lot about on this channel, prebiotic foods, of that nature, and they'll work well for you. These are the kind of foods I'd like you to eat if you've been on antibiotics, and I will have held this piece of paper up a few times for you already. Just take a screenshot. So those are foods basically high in you know, different sugars that feed the bowel up. So yes, damage can occur, but also it depends to a degree on how healthy your gut was prior to taking the antibiotics and how healthy your lifestyle is after taking them. So you can recover your gut in some cases fully, and in some cases you can never recover your gut. So depending on how you went into the antibiotic treatment. So my recommendation, don't take them unless you really have to. Follow the doctor's recommendation. Don't be an anti-antibiotic person completely, because sometimes they can do marvelous things, as long as you understand that, you know, there is a price to pay, but and recovery certainly will happen, ranging from protracted and slow up to really fast. It all depends on you. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks for the question.